mic'd up? We are rolling. Welcome to beautiful, sunny, absolutely gorgeous Hermosa Beach, California. And on this court, we have four absolutely gorgeous male specimens. Those two are wearing pink. Those two are wearing gray. Two of them are tailors. Two of them are not. Along with Aaron Wexler, I'm Jason DeBayas. Let's go.
Hey, so happy to be here, Jason. Thanks for having me.
Yes, as they shake hands, because that's the last time they're going to be cordial about this one. The last time they played against each other, Kyle Friend had 14 blocks. He was handing out blocking lessons. The former defender, Aaron Wexler.
Yeah. What a matchup right here.
Wait. I'm joined by, it's Kelly Campbell.
Here we go. Let's go.
Kyle Friend. Expect him to go to Taylor Crab. That is correct. Taylor up and down set. Taylor to Taylor inside part of the line, and that is how the Taylors strike first blood.
And that's just a tough play to defend, right? Taylor brings the whole play to the middle of the court, and he boosts so well that all the angles are wide open. Really hard to defend that play.
Nice. Taylor Crab to serve. Left shoulder serve, and Tim Brewster. Taylor, you see the disappointment in Taylor's face, right?
Yeah, he had it.
When let go?
I love to see the on-two play from the defender, which is very rare.
Nice. Jamison McKibben in the house. I see Jamison in the box. The youngest McKibben, actually set for USC. And Taylor with a nice read.
Yeah. So might have the best vision out here. Other than Billy Allen, Taylor Crabb's right there with vision.
And this really, I mean, the guy's impossible. When you're in system like that, he just reads so well. He disguises his shot so well, coach.
And he floats. He floats up there. Great jumper.
Wow, there's a jumper that trickles into the net, and now the score is two apiece. And we're gonna find out after the switch if this is a little filling out process or if they're just gonna get after
it. Yeah, both teams are just jabbing at each other.
And I will be the first one to say, don't do that. You played each other 100 times, get after it. This is not a first time meeting. Here's the back set. Taylor Crab. Wow.
Yeah, great shot. Looked like Tim had a read on it too.
And you know, sometimes some players, they usually jump, you could read the shot. Taylor jumps for power all the time, and the disguise, coach. Last minute.
Yeah.
There's a pass to Tim Brewster. There's the back set. Boy, did that one get away.
Yeah, and that's the risk, right? When you jump set like that, you're risking error. You're risking placement. You're risking a double. It's just a high-risk play.
The footwork was right, but it just got away. You know what I'm saying? Like, he didn't set him into the block. It just got shot out of a cannon.
Talk about a lollipop.
Yeah, 4-2, and there's Taylor Sander with the 5-2 switch.
Not a big fan of that jump float. I mean, jump set right there. You know, he just had an error on it. You want to kind of set your feet, get a really good set, because that set was too low.
Yeah.
Kyle Friend.
When we get to the technical timeout, we'll say a few nice things about the coaches. Two of the best coaches on the beach, at least certainly on the American scene.
Very good coaching matchup right here.
There's a, J-hook on the pass. Got it.
Sure. Yeah, go ahead.
No, I said Kyle will do that. He'll lunge and has to make sure he faces his angle on that.
Right, and strategically, you're on the good side, you got a good jumper, go for it. That's a great serve.
Yep.
That's when you want to get a point, see if you can get another one.
That's okay, and like you said, go for it. I mean, this is what it's about. I'm trying to find a way to weather the storm on what we affectionately refer to as the disadvantage side. Once again, along with Aaron Wexler.
Hello.
My man, program director and coach at West Coast Volleyball, former UCLA standout and NCAA winning coach for the women's team.
Let's go. And host of Within the Game podcast.
Within the Game. I was trying not to plug your podcast, man. You get all the rock stars, dude. There's the shoot and wow!
Great play.
Wow, that's a little bit of John Mayer, huh?
I just love that play, right? Because it's a half option pass, right? So you're spreading your offense, right? Now you got to worry about Kyle Friend going on too, but you also run the shoot set to the ocean side.
Right.
Great play.
Is that something on the ocean side that you're always pre- do for the most part, we're in a block two on that, two or four.
Ooh.
Right? You got the wind having the set drift inside a little bit.
It's a risky play.
Kind of
every single time you set into the wind like that, you're risking that set to drift. So.
So for defense, block, right? Would you instead of running a one on that, would you just run a?
At this level, you can run all kinds of stuff. I mean, you have to run all kinds of stuff. You have to run threes and fours. You can't just run ones and twos.
No, of course not. I get that totally.
And you know, on top of that, you know, I think very few players read. It's right now; these are all educated guesses, right?
Yeah. Well, if they're in system, right, and
yeah.
you disguise it so well,
mm-hmm.
you know, you kind of get caught in the educated guess. Wow, that ball, look out, right into our living room, uncharacteristicness, like you said, Vitalik.
That's a rare mistake, you know, really inside set there. I thought he was going to take that hard angle. Taylor's got the best hard angle swing, I think, on the beach, other than maybe a try or a cane.
Dude, I gotta tell you, like, as an audience, as a crowd member, it doesn't look fast, but when you're on the court trying to dig it, it's like good luck. I agree with you 100%.
There it is right there.
Wow. And once again, the jump could have been a shot or hard dribble.
And talking about Taylor Crabb, you know, maybe the best overall player. You could make a case for Kane for that, but Taylor Crabb.
Overall player where?
Overall player on the beach, period.
On the beach?
Yeah.
No, you're out of your mind.
Well,
he's not better than Ahmed. No.
No, I'm saying
he's
at not this tournament, right here.
He's not better than Lupo.
Well, those guys aren't here. I'm talking about right here, right now.
All right. Well, I'll answer it this way. He ain't even a better Crabb. Never mind better player. That's
player.
Just, no, we have opinions. And I respect, it's not like I don't respect him. No, but technique? Look at that.
Technique and first contact? Look at that.
He's like, I heard that, Jason.
It's a high level side out.
He said, I heard what you said, Jason.
It's a very high level side out. Right? He's passing from the floor, gets up, bangs line like that. That's a great play. From the bad side.
Yeah. I want to repair, not because I'm sucking up, but I want to say something nice about him after this technical timeout. Just a cool story about him.
I like that play.
I got stories about everybody. He's got one too.
I like that play right there. I like the low set to Kyle Friend on the ocean side.
Yeah.
Right? Because he's already kind of going to that spot. And he makes a great read. Jumbo pokey.
Do you think because Kyle's more of a think, react, attack guy? Or look, react, attack guy. Sorry.
Let's see what happens here. Oh, nice up. I think Kyle does great when he runs quick on his own side. When he goes backside and runs quick, I think he's in trouble.
There it is. We're three away from the technical timeout.
But,
yeah, I like it.
But earlier I was saying I think Kyle Friend and Tim Brewster are the most repped out team. They could be one of the most repped out teams on the beach, which means that they just get a ton of quality reps in practice. And, you know, you said earlier they've been playing at a high level and been progressing for the last couple of years, right?
And they do a good job not letting their relationship off the court affect how they're on the court. Taylor, transition. What a beautiful play.
Yep.
Textbook by the younger Crabb.
Yeah.
Well, y'all trapped me into that.
I will say
you
this.
You just said he's the best player on the beach. I'm like, that's
I think he's
you
close.
Trapped me into that.
You
y'all,
can make a case
y'all are
for
out of your minds,
sure.
dude.
Definitely make a case
He
for
won't
it.
Even tell you that. Right? He'll say it with me. You'll say try?
Yeah.
Well, you can make a case for try and Kane.
Yeah.
Both Olympians. And we were talking about three Olympians, right?
Taylor's
an Olympian. He could he just
So we're
go.
The technical timeout, right? So my top three American defenders, I go him, Taylor. Just a technical wizard. I go Kane Shaw, who's not talked about enough. And the third one's a toss-up. Like, Miles, on his best day, is a world beater, but at the same time, on his worst day, just looks like, what are you doing out there? So it's
well,
very,
you
very
gotta throw Billy Allen in there, too. Billy Allen's a champion.
So who's your three?
Two-time champion.
Who's your three? I'm not naming your name. Who's your three? For defenders. American defense. Not the world, because the world is... It's Ahmed, Sorum, and Lupo.
I want to speak for someone who's very, very credible.
his name John Nesco?
No.
Not good.
I was playing at 21st Street. Matt Furbringer came by.
Yes.
We were sitting there watching a bunch of people play. So just in case you're not clear, Matt Furbringer played at the highest level indoor.
Yes.
For 10 years and then the highest level beach. 10 or 15 years.
An amazing.
All the way around the world.
With multiple partners. Yeah, sorry, guy.
Didn't make the Olympics on the beach, but it was fun. He said, that day, he said, I think Taylor Crabb is the best beach volleyball player I've ever seen.
Yeah.
Wow.
Yeah. He has the best body control.
Yeah.
Right? If you watch him play.
Yeah, it was a big statement.
And for anyone that heard what John Mesko said, he said Furby said Taylor's the best beach volleyball player he's ever seen. So for my audience members, all right, you got a former champion here at UCLA. You got Furbringer, one of the best of the games, and you got a moron from Brooklyn. So our opinions, definitely take it or leave it when it comes to mine. Yeah.
And
but I will defend myself. Who are the best announcers in the world? They're the Brooklyn kids, baby.
But while we're talking about defenders, you got to give Tim Brewster some love. I mean,
yes.
Maybe the most improved defender, right? He's playing great ball.
But Mesko, no one would kick up a fuss if they said it was a two-horse race between Kame and Taylor for American defenders. But when you said the world, I'm like, y'all on crack, dude.
It's a nice high swing.
And as long as Furbring has been playing, he need to watch a video of Qatar. Because that dude is the best defender no one talks about. Ahmed is the best defender no one talks about.
That's a great high swing by
yes.
Taylor Sander there. Challenging.
Beautiful, yeah.
Challenging the block.
You know what they have in common, though? When Taylor gets a dig, you're at the edge of your seat because you know he's going to do something gnarly. Ooh.
There's that risk again, right, with that jump
yeah.
set.
And this time from the other guy.
It's too risky. You don't want to do it too much on a high spinny pass like that.
It looks not. I don't mind the risk. It has to be practiced. And that looks not practiced.
Well, that's two errors, right? You're giving away 2 points already.
And there he is!
Ooh, incoming.
I have something to say about that last play.
What's that?
I say it to a lot of teams when that happens. I go, everybody wants to be Miles Partain.
That's true.
Exactly.
Or
right?
The Swedes.
I mean,
right?
But talk about a guy who's changed the game. Miles Partain changed the game with that jump set.
Yes. And years of not cutting corners in your training.
Ooh.
Wow! Splits the uprights. 16-10,
that's
Taylor Sander.
Yeah, that's the problem with serving Taylor Sander. Yeah.
Wow. Think about that.
Yeah. Taylor, you can't really serve Taylor Sander because of that reason right there.
There's a line over. And there is so much about Tim Bruce's game that reminds me of John Mayer.
Yeah,
like
nice
like a poor man's
there.
John, a poor man's Mayer.
Yeah.
Is it because he's left-handed?
It's because he's left-handed.
But he's
no, but if you look at his cross courts, Mesko. His cross court, his wrist away is gross.
But the improvement over the last couple years has been awesome.
Wow. Oh. Taylor with a big smile on his face. He's like, he said, you know you bit the bait on that one. And
okay.
There's your switch.
Now, I got to say something about Coach Evie, right? Because I know Coach Evie Matthews well, and he's a big fan of that tricky offense like that, right? The inside fake to the outside shoot set and vice versa. He trains it, right? And you're seeing the Taylors run that tricky offense like that. And it's super hard to defend. It's super frustrating to defend because you don't really know where to go.
Yep.
Right?
Amen. Yeah.
And you're seeing more and more teams experiment with that tricky offense, the fake to the in, the shoot it out, fake to the out, shoot it in.
And look at Taylor just lobbing them in and allowing them to self-implode. And I think it's an intelligent serve, right? I know we don't like to serve lollipops, but their defensive scheme, their blocking scheme is tricky.
Does that. Alessandro does that. Bonsky does that.
Yeah.
Yeah, you trust your
defense.
No,
it's about letting them stay in system and seeing how close they set to the net and to this huge block. There's a touch, finally stops the bleeding at least for 1 point. The score is 12-19.
What do you think about serve receiving with your hands that you're seeing sometimes on the FIVB?
I think, as legal as it is, it's ill-advised. Because you take away from your setter's court vision, trajectory-wise, because it's coming from a higher place. Where the bump pass from a lower place, the setter gets a lot some of his peripheral vision for the option, which is the more more popular thing the last couple of years. So
I don't think the AVP allows it, and I hope they don't change
the AVP. It is in their rules. They do allow it. CBVA does not. CBVA, to their credit, wrote into their rules.
Have you seen one?
You
today?
Can't do that. No.
I haven't either.
No, but I did see Travis Muirwood hand set a sky ball for Kane Shaw. It was a Canadian game. I'll tell you in a minute. This is 13-19 and
this
wow, gonna need two blockers for that one. Set point opportunity number one for Taylor Sander.
You've got 7 chances.
Yep.
Wonder. I like these odds.
Yeah, this is a tough match. I think I'm gonna put $20 on Sander and crap. Position 4. Why not? Everything's been going their way. Why the heck not, right? Hmm? Yeah.
Tough matchup for Brewster.
No, this is a rematch from when Brewster got 14 blocks against this team. This is ultimate reversal, because the last time they played, Brewster and Friend handled them.
When was that?
Well, the last time I saw them play, it was a gold series. That was at Atlanta.
Ooh.
Wow, and there it is. There's your game one.
They played in that Tuesday. They played in that Tuesday
absolutely
morning qualifier for Narseca. And Brewster and Friend won that.
So, Coach, check it out, right? Cool story about Taylor, right? He comes on my podcast, right? And then he hears I did a true or false thing. True or false, one of the Crabs are going to win a AVP.
Uh-huh.
And I said false, neither Crab's going to win,
you
right?
You said false.
Yeah, and because the category was called true or false, seeing the future. So an hour later, he sends me a message because he just won New York with Jay Gibb. And he says, dude, you need to work on your future seeing skills, bro. I mean, the kid is thick-skinned. He can hear everything I'm saying and can take it.
And I like that he likes the smack talk, too.
Yeah.
I like that. I think the sport needs more of that.
But I love you that know? he said, you need to work on your future seeing skills, bro.
That's pretty good.
It was the best text ever.
I love that. I feel bad for him about the Olympics, you know, getting COVID and not being able to participate. I mean, he was right there, and he really deserved to be in there, right? He worked real hard with Jake Gibb to get there.
Now, I mentioned him and Ahmed in the same category. Do you know what they have in common? When they get a dig, you're at the edge of your seat because you know whatever comes next is chair-worthy.
Yeah.
Like when Ahmed gets a dig, do you think he's shooting?
No. He's coming
he's,
in to hit.
He's bombing the hell out of him, dude.
Yep.
And the same thing about Taylor. When Taylor gets a dig, you're at the edge of your seat, Coach, and you're like, oh, something's coming, and boom, there it is. And I hope this team stays together. I expect to see them in 2028, and hell, they might have a good shot at 2024.
Well, our friend Mesko here makes a good point. You know, Taylor has a great opportunity to make a lot of money on the indoors circuit, and he's choosing to be out here. I'm not sure how much longer he can do that, because you're leaving
Look,
a lot of money on
if
the
if he's in the Italian League, I'm always going to say play in the Italian League.
Game
this two. Is my jam. A little Drake. There's a remix too with Bieber and Drake.
Good read. Ooh.
And that's and
okay.
Listen,
Timmy
Aaron,
Brewster.
That's what I meant when I said he's got a little John Mayer.
That's
in
a nice play.
He has this slow, methodical approach, that little good, better, best thing going, and then all of a sudden, blah blah blah.
I like those the tempo set in transition too. That's real tough to defend. Looked like he went OT.
Taylor Crabb creating a string out of the middle. Up and down set, Taylor. Wow, child's play. Teardrop for the tie.
And there's that shot I was talking about earlier, the underutilized short line shot. So hard to defend.
So, for top 5 defenders in the world, I got Crabb in that conversation.
He has to be.
I got him there with Lupo, Ahmed, and you got to give Christian Soam the rub, regardless of the
Soam's
block.
Right in that mix, too.
Now, all of them have very capable blocks. But when you think of great blocks between Andrews Mull and Jay Gibb, you don't think of Sharif. That's why, you know, Sharif's a good block. And that's why I give Ahmed the rub. Ooh, what was that? There's the up and down, and Kyle. What?
Nice game.
There's the one-arm bandit, and here we go. Transition!
Ooh.
What did I say before?
Great play. That's a great play.
Talk Coach, did I not say that? When he gets a dig, you're at the edge of your seat. Go ahead.
But I like the way he held his position as Friend stared him down, and he showed, basically Taylor showed that the line was wide open.
Mm-hmm.
And he didn't move.
switch. Good play. And wow. And right into our living room, and now the score's 2-0.
And that's what Fred needs. He needs that height when he runs that back set like that.
Dude, look, I'm surrounded by all of these absolute beach savages. So Aaron Wexler, I got John Mesko with me. Let's do a keys to game two. What do Brewster and Friend have to do better to bring this to game
less
three?
Errors.
Start with you, Aaron.
Less errors, you know? Just be a little bit more consistent with the setting.
Okay.
You know, and then find the pocket to go for it on the good side like they just did. Like, that was a good serve, you know?
Yep.
But yeah, less errors and finding the moment.
Mess, what do you see, man, for game two?
I'd like to speak for Karch. I think he would say you got to side out.
Yes. Yeah, siding out shouldn't be trivial.
That's a nice set.
There he is. And again, right into the living room of the camera. Giving it to the ball person. Wow. I've never been known to be gender careful, but that was... Jesus. I think I got to turn in my old school card. That's a lady.
A great swing by Kyle Friend right there.
Tim Brewster, serve out of the middle. And Taylor right now has
good
been
gig.
High percentage out of the middle. This time they get a dig. Wow. A little bit of a hot dog on that dig. He didn't love that. And he got what he kind of had that coming.
That's a nice play.
There's your switch.
That's a nice play all the way around. I love how no one gave up on that play.
That's what Kyle and Tim are famous for.
Yeah. That scramble.
Turning lemons into lemonade, yeah.
Right,
look,
and guys,
I know firsthand. I had to coach against them at Huntington. I had Jeff Samuels and Ralphie Polis, and these guys can scrap, man. These guys can scrap. We were in the draw against them in Huntington Beach. I expect them to go back to Crab. And I expect the same kind of luck balloon serve, maybe.
There's that
nice
offense.
Fake on the back set and coming out.
Yeah, great offense.
Oh shit, he got it.
Tim's gonna run it now.
Tim is really good at one move to the ball, coach. Making one move to the ball, and I think that gives him a shot at everything. Ooh. Ouchie.
Nice pass.
Ooh,
I like that.
Picasso.
But that all gets established from that first contact, right? That beautiful pass. I love this coaching right in the middle of the play here.
They're not allowed. The ref's looking at him. He's not allowed to do that.
Well, they're letting that go right now.
They are.
I'm cool with it.
Look, you got two coaches that have diplomatic immunity, man. You got Evie Matthews and Leandro Pinheiro. I love Leandro, but I'm tired of seeing him every time I have
nice
to go
pass.
Against him. There's Taylor with the self-cover. Sander, what a dig! Batting cleanup. No, there's a dig. Brewster, transition! Taylor! Oh my god, I could really do without the hot dog dig though. And there's your line over!
Good rally. Great rally, nice digs. I love how Tim Brewster comes out of nowhere sometimes.
Yes.
And just slips into the line or the angle and just gets a great dig.
What I didn't love, and I sound like I'm crapping on Taylor, I'm not doing it. I did love the low hot dog show-offy thing. The game is more beautiful. Just put it up, dude.
I'm curious why Sander went on two there.
People are gonna be mad when this goes out on YouTube, but someone gotta keep it real.
And after a long scramble play like that, you gotta put the ball in.
Yep. Dude, very, very awesome rally. And now it's 5-6, yeah?
And a big part of this game is slowing it down, right? Especially after a long scramble play, you gotta take a deep breath and slow it down for a second. Reset.
Serve out of the middle. Left shoulder serve to a lefty. And wow, nice read by Taylor. And Taylor got it!
And the stare down. Just a great read. And again, great patience on the set. Set was a little tight. Just went and grabbed it.
And I like. Back to this conversation on best defender, I think that's why Taylor's in that discussion.
He has to be.
Every time that guy gets a dig, you're at the edge of your seat. Because
well,
you know something gnarly is going to happen. There's a dig, and watch. Transition, crab, of course.
And he also has the best wrist action at the very top of his swing. place the ball, but he can also snap it really fast to the open court.
Look,
like he just did.
Coach, you're sitting next to me. I got a whole bunch of people sitting next to me. On that dig, who didn't see that point coming? We all saw it coming.
Right?
It was almost, you know. Like I said, I'm one of his biggest critics for this match, but come on. I'm going to be real both ways. I'm always be real.
Hmm? But that's why I said he's. You can make a case that he's one of the best players out here because he was also player of the year indoors as a 6-foot outside hitter for Long Beach State,
2013.
So you're talking about one of the best defenders and one of the best offensive players.
Can we talk about something important?
No, we were saying Taylor was a player of the year, Long Beach State indoor.
Can we talk about something important?
Oh, not indoor.
What do you
got, beach.
What do you got?
I want to talk about beach.
I want to talk about six men.
Oh, six when's that coming up?
We've got a sneaky team, and I'm throwing out a blanket. Whoever wants to bet, heads up. I'm talking Soho, Lionstall, 12th Street. Whoever wants it, Fletch. I'll go $100 max, $500 that we will finish higher than you.
I'm with it.
I like
Ladies
that.
And gentlemen, you heard it here, man. Stein Metzger.
Stein Metzger.
John Mesko.
He calls me Metzger.
Nice dig. Yes. Nice
There's
dig.
No way John moves to Texas.
There's the scramble play again.
Great
a little bit of a scramble
play.
There.
I expect this match to be a little bit closer. Let's talk serving strategy. Do they stay with Taylor Crabb on this one?
You gotta go to Crabb because if you put it to Sanders on the good side, on the bad side,
right?
And it's kind of an automatic kill. So
I
you gotta stay on
middle
Crabb.
And expect Taylor.
Oh!
I like the switch, but it's really, really hard to dig when you're on the move, right?
He had a good read on it. He just kind of hit the net.
Is that something where you try to stop before the swing, or you just got to go on the move?
No, you got to try to stop. Like, we're always taught as defenders, be still when the opponent is hitting. So you got to do your best to just try to stop for a second.
Tim Brewster, net ball, left balloons out of bounds. Look out, right into our living room. Everybody be careful. Three things get hit by beach balls out here. Starbucks coffee cups. Cell phones and 11-year-old little girls. We gotta be careful. Gotta have your head up, guys. Nice deep serve, control serve, and man.
Tough to defend a lefty on the right on the option play.
Yeah.
It's hard to defend.
But at the same time, like you said, Taylor, one move to the ball everywhere he goes. That's a ball that, like, we felt he probably could have had, right?
Yep. I see a jumper middle here.
Back set. Nice fluidity on that. Great look, and boy, Tim hit the ground first before he hit that ball, and he'd love to have that one back.
Slightly moving there, right? Yeah. He just stays a little bit more still. Maybe he makes that play.
I think he hit his knee and then shook his forearms, and there it is, 2 points away from the technical timeout. Leading by one in the set, leading 1-0 in the match are the Taylors. There's a very good pass.
Ooh.
And my goodness.
That's nice. That's real nice.
In New York, we have this thing called 10-10 wins. Give us 22 minutes, we'll give you the world. It's a news station.
I like
10-10 wins.
I love
in
that,
California.
That quick arm swing like that, right? It's just quick.
Speaking
quick.
Of Long Beach State, right? He's got a quick one. Long Beach State shining. And there's a easy as candy play by
that
Taylor.
That wrist action I was talking about, right? The top almost looks like a basketball shot. Just wristing it right to the ocean corner.
So, listen, as we're at the technical timeout, talking to some of our California kids, that's you. A Kyle Friend was part of a boom period for Long Beach State, right? Where there were a lot of good players on his team, Duncan Budinger, and do you remember any of those guys?
Of course.
The team?
Oh, yeah. I mean, Long Beach State's been a powerhouse for a while. But
but they have these boom periods. Once every 4 or 5 years, it's like, wow, David Lee, Matt Prosser, right? And that was probably around your time, right?
Yeah, they've always been. They're always in the mix. They've been Alan Knight, great coach.
Yeah. A long time, 1990s, yeah.
Yeah.
First time I saw Alan Knight, Team Cup Volleyball. Mm. The beach players get together, play indoor sixes. They move the 10-foot line to the 15-foot line, and one person from the back row can come up and block.
Huh.
okay.
Four blockers, two defenders. Like so for the, my people on YouTube, YouTube search Team Cup Volleyball. And all of the sponsors came out. Coca-Cola, Toyota, Paul Mitchell, big volleyball sponsor.
And speaking of sponsors, let's give a shout out. We got Wilson, we got Kona Big Wave, we got White Claw, we got Waiakea. What else we got out here? This new energy drink that I had some today. It was nice. Rain Storm. Suja.
Suja.
Yeah, it's nice to see all the sponsors.
Absolutely.
Better at beach. Beach.
Dude, tough socks is super necessary today.
Love to see it.
Like Horton and Bauer, man, their feet were kind of hollering. They had a late morning or early afternoon game, and the sand was hollering at their feet as we're back in the technical timeout. Again, leading by one in the set and the match.
Got a good game going on here. A lot of chess out there.
Taylor Crabb takes something off of that J-hook pass a little bit. Low set and Taylor, great balance. And transition. Wow. What a set! Up and down set. Taylor sees it!
Nice dig.
Big smile on his face and stabbing the gas tank.
Well, because he had an open
Taylor
net.
Taylor Crabb and Taylor Sanders.
Brent had an open net and put it right into Taylor Crabb's lap.
Fantastic. Make sure your lapel good. Make sure your lapel's right.
Check, check. One, two. Thanks for watching, everybody. Happy to be here.
And thanks for listening to me and Aaron. You got the positive growth mindset guy. You got the hater from New York. And here we are.
Nice on two there's option.
There's an option. Par for the course option.
Right.
Something I guarantee my audience is fair and honest dealing. I'm not going to say nice things about someone just because they're here. I'm going to be fair.
And, you know, I appreciate that about you, you know, calling it like you see it, you know, adding some spice here and there.
It's like you don't think I want to see these two in the Olympics. Hell yeah, I want to. They're good for volleyball.
Nice touch.
Right? They're good for volleyball.
Absolutely.
They make the Olympics.
Absolutely. Olympics.
It's going to be very difficult for them to make it to Paris.
Agreed. I mean, I'm just happy that we got one team in the top 20 now. I looked 3 weeks ago and Miles Partain and Benesh were 19 in the men. The women, you had like six in the top 15. It was crazy.
And this is an exciting time, right? Pre-Olympic year. Everyone's kind of getting hungry for it, ramping up.
Miles has taught male players a lesson in not cutting corners in practice. There's the block. Like, consider this, right? And I got Mesko with me, too. And you can answer yes to all three of these questions. Are there players in the AVP taught faster than Miles? Yes. Jump higher? Yes. Hit harder? Yes. But yet, there he is, and there they are. It's because he doesn't cut corners on technique. It's exercise
Miles
to
Partain?
An inch of his life. Yes.
Yeah.
But we can check all the boxes on all the players who are bigger, stronger, and faster than him. But yet, there he is, and there they are, as we're at a timeout here, 14-11.
Now, can someone answer me this? Why did Stad happen at the exact same time Hermosa?
Stad is every year at the same time.
Well, why did Hermosa, why did the AVP schedule this event at the exact same time?
It is a complicated answer.
Because that shouldn't happen.
No.
Right? Because we're also missing Sarah Hughes and Kelly Chang. They're out there. Right?
Right.
Yeah, I mean, you know, kind of it's a bit of a disservice to the whole sport to double up like that. Especially in a pre-Olympic year.
Chicken or the egg on this one, right? Like, the AVP deserves all the credit it deserves, particularly the last
definitely,
3 years.
Definitely.
You
know, I'm just saying a little foresight and a little planning.
There's definitely something logistical that we're not privy to that might have forced their hand at
I'm just saying, I'm a fan of the game, right?
Yep.
I want to see the best players play.
The men came through, at least for Hermosa, right? The only male
nice.
I think the only male team right now is Partain and Benesh.
Oh. Open net. He should have hit that one. Yeah, that was an open net. All right, they got to stop the bleeding here. Need to get a side out. 15 serving 11. pass. That's a good option. Yeah. That's a great option play.
So sorry, guys. I had to send a very important text to Corey Brindell, who's the director of the Motherlode.
And that's
what
we want.
He's here in California.
As a right side defender, you're down by a few points. You want to put up an option and get your blocker going, trying to get a little bit of momentum.
I call me weird, but because Kyle's such a good hard-driven ball blocker, go to Sander. Right?
Yeah, I think so too. I mean, Taylor Crabb's been dialed in. You know, the whole game, you got to switch it up.
I mean, if there's a strategic thing that was supposed to set him up for the long game, it's not working because
right.
Taylor's gas. Look at Taylor's gas tank. He hasn't even used a gallon of gas in the 15-gallon tank.
I got a buddy in Evergreen that has a
doesn't have to compete serve.
I actually like that serve.
There goes Taylor. Here
Woo!
Comes the show.
Wow.
You know what's weird? I wanted to say here comes the
wow.
show before he swung. And go ahead, Coach.
I'm just saying, it's a great swing, but it's also a beautiful set. He's Taylor Crabb's fading away, falling down, put up a butter set for him. All right, 13 serving 17. Let's see if Friend can dial one up here. At this point in the game, you got to dial it up. You just got to go for it.
Maybe switch to Sander. Again, most of his blocks, he had 14 blocks, but all of the blocks came from hard-driven balls. He's not out there blocking shots, you know?
There's a chance.
He's got to compete. There's nobody up. He has to call nobody up. There's the drifter, a little wind, right?
That's a tough one,
makes a drift inside.
Yeah.
And look, it's easier said than done from where I'm sitting my Brooklyn butt, but just the same, there it is.
Coach Evie over here studying the game. Talking to his guys.
Evie's like, you guys keep looking at me. Just keep doing what you're doing.
Evie's awesome.
There he is.
That's nice. Come on, Mesko. Give me a dig over here.
Oh, she caught it. I thought she dropped that touchdown pass.
That's a nice on two play.
It was, yeah. And again, he's got that good, better, best thing that Mayer has. That slow, gradual thing. And then it flies off his hand. Heavy. It's a whip.
Not a fan of that serve. Standing floater right to Taylor Crabb, but that's a good dig.
I actually like the serve, but
set. What a set. Right?
Lefty too.
Yeah.
Jumping against
set.
The wind, against the grain.
That's a nice
you
real point.
You gotta be kidding me.
That's a nice real point right there.
Yeah. A little momentum, huh? Now I do like the serve location, but the estimated time of arrival, right? If Taylor can make two moves at midline,
at this point
it's
in the
no
game,
longer an effective serve.
It's just too easy.
Right.
But
location's good. I just want some zip there.
Nice play.
Yeah.
The serve's too easy. At this point in the game, you're down a set and you're down by 3 or 2 points. Yeah, they were just down by 3, yeah.
If they play everybody else the same way they played, they're playing this team, they'll win the whole thing. Taylor and Taylor are on fire.
They just feel like, it just seems like they're just so relaxed. Look at that, relaxed.
Why not? Transition volleyball, everything else is working, take a swing.
All right, if you're down by 3 points right here, like Friend and Brewster, you still have a chance. The mindset is we got a chance, let's go.
All right.
Don't give up. Don't slow down.
Now, look, again, kid from Brooklyn, but in my defense, longtime coach, go to Sander, Taylor Sander, left shoulder, 4 block. You got wind pushing this way. You got wind pushing left to right to left on our TV screen.
Hey!
And that's it.
There it is right there.
Except I don't want him going right shoulder where he can run the back set.
Right.
I want left shoulder, ISO play, and jump in.
That's a nice read. I think that was a read block.
Yes. In fact, I wouldn't even go. I would go 4 block on the net and 2 block, two defender on the switch.
That's a serving mistake. You just got a block on Sander.
That
prove
ball's
me wrong.
Out of bounds.
Way to prove me wrong, though.
Man. And as a general rule, 3 points is a timeout. That's Evie.
I like the soundtrack right now.
Evie Matthews, yeah.
Evie.
DJ Roche, maybe, right? I've had some real DJs.
What's going on here, Mesco? Talking about the Ballmark? There we go. Got a good little game right here. 18 serving 19.
Chewbacca action by Tim Brewster.
See if they get three in a row. They just got a point on both Taylors. I think they're going to try Crab here.
Oh, no. Taylor Crab. Was that a mistake? Oh, there it is. He's going option.
Oh! Oh!
Yes.
That's huge. That's three in a row. Timeout.
And now, maybe we were right in retrospect.
Wow. And they took that mindset, right? They were down by three. They said, let's go. They got three in a row.
For the audience listening at home, everyone in the tent, sitting in this tent, from volleyball pro to, like, run of the mill was saying, call timeout. Like the play before this is like, dude, you gotta call timeout.
I love that run. What a great run.
Great, yeah.
Let's see if they can keep it going. They just scored on Taylor Sander, then Crab again.
And it's weird because I thought they served the wrong Taylor but got the right result. So what the hell do I know, right?
Now who do you serve now? I'd probably go right back to Crab, but I'd look for the on two.
I think so, yeah.
I'd look for the on two, but all the momentum and adrenaline is on this side, right? Side of Friend and Brewster. See if they can contain it. Sometimes on a timeout call, you miss your serve because you're so excited, and that's the purpose of calling a timeout, trying to ice the other team. Let's see if they can keep that serve in and get another real point.
Do you know what's crazy, too? The Taylors are usually the team that's sneaky. They give up a lead, and they sneak through the back door and win. And this is the team that's being sneaky this time. Leandro, there he is.
This is what you want to see right here. 19-all Formosa Open, day one, Friday.
Dude,
packed crowd.
Is there any place we'd rather be, Coach, than right here?
This is
on
awesome.
Court two. North of the pier. That ball's out! Oh,
and that's why you call a timeout.
My goodness.
The adrenaline was pumping. But, okay, they still have a chance here. Let's see if they can side out.
That luff balloon was Nina worthy.
And
match point opportunity number one is here.
And if that happens, you got to immediately forget about that and side out. Watch the middle tough serve right here.
Middle serve? I think they're going to go Kyle's right shoulder. There it is. Oh, and the tip. And
oh.
Man, Taylor just goes. And that's the same look Taylor Crab had previously. Like, man, I had that.
That's a smart
yeah.
play. That's so smart because of this flip block.
Yes.
They had the blocker defending.
It's one of the first times I think they did a split block this whole game.
And this one, Taylor's right shoulder again. There's a little bit of a shank, but. And he got his hand caught in the cookie jar on that one. Sometimes indecisive works against you, right?
If they can side out, they switch, go back to the good side. Might have a good chance here. They need to get this side out.
And sometimes if you're going for it, even if you think it's out, once you go all the way. Because you'll shank more balls being indecisive and. Wow.
Good side
great
out.
Balance, and here we are.
I mean, that was the whole game plan.
Dude, we're on men's match number three on court two, and every time we say this was match of the day, the next one trumped it, and this one is in the middle of trumping it. If it goes to game three, we got to give it to Rub, but right now, the previous match was. Yeah. But the previous match with Baumgren and Lottman was awesome.
Friend back to serve.
Against Alisson and Bruno. Or was it? No, it was Evans and.
Oh! Oh!
What a thing! And there it is!
Wow. Nice, Brewster. That was nice.
Okay, guys.
For that was nice.
Making my fans recording this, I'm just going to shut up.
That's a Pat and Brewster friend play.
Right?
People
that
watching
is,
this
that's
recording
are going to
be
play.
Like, thank God this guy shut up because
let's see
I'm going
to
be quiet for the next play.
Let's see if they can get two in a row. Yeah.
Wow.
Yeah. Great body control there. Nice side out. Momentum is still on the side of Brewster and Friend,
yeah.
though.
22 up. Very good last minute read by Taylor Sander, huh?
Yeah.
Taylor Sander cut his teeth at BYU. two-time Olympian, 2012, right, 2016? Or was it 16 and 20?
Oh.
Oh, my goodness. Talk about right place, right time. Sander. And friend. Good dig by Taylor. Up and down set. Taylor. Got it! Krabs won. Taylor's gonna listen to this video and be like, I ain't talking to Jason. There's the drifter set and there's the dig. This could be the match. That's his set. Up and down. Yeah. Boom!
Wow.
Taylor Crabb
nice
calmly,
fight,
patiently, methodically finishes.
Good fight though. Good
in
fight.
A hard fought second set, but nonetheless, winners 2-0. Anyone whose first name is Taylor, beat the boys in pink, winner's bracket. Along with John Mesko, along with Aaron Wexler,
yes.
Coach Wexler, along with my crew, my bodyguards, I'm Jason DeBilius. Do we stick around for one more? You'll never know. We're out. Later.
Peace.